Reading Cat Hill's new book Bothy reminds me of the importance of magical secrets and a place to hide, and why it is important to share the experience of a secret hideaway without revealing its location on a map or showing pictures on social media. The description of the secret Bothy Hauf in words allows each of us to paint a personal mental picture without trying to make us visit the place. Don't we all have our own secret hideaways? The dilemma I face is how to depict the citadel behind my cabin in all its splendor and magic without attracting hordes of tourists with slick drone footage. Will it still be the place I encountered 22 years ago? Will it change the people in the community, and how? Many people feel the urge to travel far to experience magical secrets for themselves. The further, the better. Fortunately, they pass through the north of France on their way south. And hopefully they will continue to do so. I hope to facilitate and inspire that you can find a cultivated natural landscape almost everywhere. You have to take a closer look. Thank you.
Thank you.
like an army rolling down the hillside. These sunflowers seemed to be on the move, like foot soldiers for the Lord of the Rings, marching in the warm wind. Amazing how they turn their faces away from the sun in the afternoon to protect their precious oil from overheating. Fortunately, I found this patch of famous flower giants still in full bloom. Most fields in the region have lost their luminescence and are busy breeding large quantities of seeds. Tucked away in this quiet, almost secret valley, a farmer had probably gambled on planting late in the season. Are prices going up or down? Yellow sunflower fields are more plentiful every year, as are rapeseed fields in spring. Demand for oil as a staple crop is growing as the war in Ukraine continues. But it has also sparked interest in specialty vegetable oils, such as camelina and safflower. The local oil mill produces an exceptional cold-pressed virgin sunflower oil. Its taste and its story piqued my interest and readiness to meet and get to know these friendly giants of the landscape. A solitary tree always catches my attention. Many trees tell a story and their experience of what they've seen. There is a logic to why trees have witnessed or participated in hangings and other gruesome human activities, as well as myths and pagan ceremonies. So lonely, now that we know that trees are social creatures, sharing information and taking care of each other. Is this one abandoned or too old, like elephants do with their elders? On the other hand, it gets a lot of attention and light, and no cows to eat the lower branches. Do notice the lonely trees and ask yourself what you would do if you were that tree. Robert Persick's famous book on motorcycle maintenance comes to mind when thinking about the art of berry picking. Foraging food can be endured as a necessary chore, but it can also be an activity in which one can indulge. There is no better way to be in the here and now than to harvest the overwhelmingly flavorful and colorful blackberries and elderberries. How do I get lost in thought and ignore all the thorns and nettles? Concentrate on one berry and don't look behind it. See it, feel it, taste it, and move on to the next. Think of it as a meaningful way to be present. When I was growing up, my father was always eager to take us on a berry picking hike. Wild blueberries here in Europe are small and it takes forever to fill a cup. But working together and constantly passing the berries to a central bucket worked as a strategy. Now it has become more of a solitary activity that allows the opportunity for peace in mind if I allow the silence to settle in. And ideas will come as I reflect on my life here in France.